Anderson Pierre back again. Late night, exhausted, but I will do a beer ramble tonight. And tonight we're looking at Singing River IPA. Our friends at the Singing River Brewery Company in Florence, Alabama. Beer Advocate, 6.2% alcohol by volume in American IPA style. The Beer Advocate nor the Olsen Brothers, the bros, have not scored this beer. It gets a 19 score for the style and a 44 score overall. This beer, I'm guessing, came out in 2014, which is the same time that the brewery had opened. The brewery, Singing River, which is in a base in Florence. Anyway, here's what the IPA looks like. A nice little amber color, right? You can see a nice little top right here. Very pretty looking beverage here. Onto the scent. Nice. German malts and definitely in this. Definitely have those citrus scents of most India pale ales. Quite fragrant, quite pungent. To me, I liked it. Definitely some of those German hops are in this. Smell it already. Really smells really nice and love the head on this. On to the drink. Definitely nice. Sorry I'm being distracted right now. I'm about to shut it down for the night. Oh boy. Good IPA. Good. Definitely malty. It's not a bitter finish on this beer at all. A little tinge of sweetness in the end. I can feel it on my lips. But there's no bitter bite to this at all. And this is quite good. Yeah, this is all right. The brewery, Singing River, started by Robert and Michelle Jones, a nice looking married couple, started the brewery in 2014. And most of their beers right now are sold in the northern central part of the state, northern part of the state of Alabama. I guess recently we started getting some of their beers here, probably not too long ago. I found this at the hookup store. And it was a nice place, the hookup store. And get some from time to time, get beers that I haven't really tried for about half the cost, which is I like. But this was but the brewery so far, like I said, they've reached parts of Tennessee. They're in, you know, they're right on the border of Alabama, you know, most of like the central northern part of the state, you know, where they reach out, you know, Tennessee, as I mentioned, Quad City, Tennessee, you know, somewhere near the, I want to say Meridian, Mississippi, I guess somewhere in that vicinity, Huntsville, I mentioned, Decatur, you know, most of their beers are sold there. So, and And like I said, we just probably recently maybe started getting some of their stuff here. They only have three everyday beers. They have a porter, and they have a blonde ale, and then they have couple of seasonals. One of the seasonals is Kodachrome, of course, which is named after the song that Paul Simon had put out. Kodachrome against the night. Okay. Yes, you were sadly too subjected to my singing. Horrible. Anyway, that song was recorded in Muscle Shoals at a recording studio in Muscle Shoals, Alabama, where a lot of the preeminent rock and jazz and blues acts and country acts recorded a lot of their music during that time. There was a documentary that came out maybe a couple of months ago, maybe a year ago, about Muscle Shoals, that recording studio, from those past and present. Yes, even I think the studio is still producing music now. But anyway, back to the beer. And the company. So far again, a young and so far, if I've seen what the Rapier score says, what it is, looks like this brewer is going to be around for a little while longer. Standard IPA is not, it's very mild, not overly done. There's no bitterness to this whatsoever. A little tang of citrus, maybe orange, grapefruit, but more grapefruit than orange in this. Overall, this is a very, very good IPA. And I compare this with a nice maybe rotisserie chicken, or maybe probably some fried veal parmesan. I could probably go good with this if they're gonna pair this with. I think that would be good. Cut through all the spices and all the flavors to it. So a nice something like that, or a nice good said Cornish game hen with some potatoes and some mixed vegetables. That'd be kind of cool to pair with this. So yeah, this is a good beer pairing with this. So I don't see anything negative with this at all. I think they did a pretty good job with this IPA. And Alabama's really starting to kind of get a very good reputation of a lot of good craft beers. I mean, reputation of being a good spot to get some really for those outside of the state. Hey, Alabama's not bad, for craft beers, as people like to talk, hey, yeah, I've tried some of the good people. Yeah, I've tried some of that, Band of Brothers. Yeah, I've tried some of that, Back 40 beer. Yeah, I tried some of that of, Fairhope. I tried this, and I think that's good. And for someone living down here who has been critical in a kind way of some of the beers, sold in the state, and in terms of what they're doing, I think that they're really doing a bang up job in what they're putting out right now. So, call me crazy, whatever, but I think it's some good things are coming along for this beer. And I think they're quite, I think that's a good thing on a personal level. So, like I said, I really do enjoy this. This is good. And I have another can which I'm going to save for tomorrow when I get off. Yeah, I'm gonna shut it down for the night, man. I'm just dead fucking dead bloody tired. It's been a long day, but anyway, I'm gonna give this thing an A 8.5, so that should be about a B plus 8.5 seems about a good score. I don't know what a B plus or maybe A minus. I don't know. So 9 is an A. No, 10 is a super A. Anyway, 8.5 for the. I ain't gonna go on the scores. And score for me. So this is a very good brew, and I'm really enjoying this. So if you've had Singing River IPA, I think it's worth the 8.5 score, maybe lower than that, higher. Leave your comments and thoughts on the bottom. So 8.5 score for me, a very, very good India Pale Ale. John Anderson Pierre, the Beer Ramble, so you keep on watching. And as always, cheers. Good night, America.